at Home Depot getting PVC parts to fix our well system. Yep, and of course they're out of 1-inch 10-foot PVC pipe because it is the most popular PVC pipe. I'm pretty sure they have some in the back somewhere that we have to ask for. But, yeah.
Here's the lights.
Huh?
Here's the lights, too. I'm glad they're taking on. Whatever. Yeah.
See, he was talking about this pipe, because this pipe goes into that pipe. That's what he was talking about. But he was talking about it straight up and down. That one just goes straight.
Yeah.
No, that's a different pipe. The other guy was saying that there was a main.
That is the main pipe, because that is your switch.
Yeah, this is the main one. You got this 1-inch goes from here all the way to the house.
Yeah,
that's what I thought.
And then when it goes under the house, it breaks down to 3/4, which ties into your house.
Yeah, and
yeah, he was talking about that.
Is 1-inch PVC though? He was talking about a bigger pipe.
Or this one right here that goes underneath into the ground.
Well, I didn't see that one.
That's what he was talking about. Is the width, the diameter of that one.
I didn't see that one until just now.
That was split too.
That's why I couldn't explain it. I was like, I know what he's talking about.
Well, I just didn't see that until now.
No, you're fine.
I looked in here for like, 5 minutes between me and you?
Yeah.
And I haven't seen this thing since, so.
This whole piece got
My uncle did some research. He told me to get these both because use these together and it makes it last like 2 times longer. I have no idea. But
this is the stuff I was telling you about.
It's like $3 extra.
Yeah, it's the stuff I told you about, the cleaner.
Yeah.
It cleans the pipe and then that's the glue.
That's the
it's called glue, but they put cement on it.
Yeah, I knew what you meant. It's funny because I was like, it's like the cement glue that we grew up with.
I'm so specific. Like, if someone tells me to get glue, I'll get glue.
Yeah. I'm the opposite. I'm like, it's the same thing.
I'm thinking in my head, but you know.
Oh, I know what you mean.
Regular glue and cement, they act two different ways for different things.
Take that off.
But.
Take this. I might break my ear.
I told Jim, I said, the only reason why I'm going to film this is for our future reference and to say any idiot can do this.
Yeah, that's what I want to see. Nice. Not any ice coming out of that yet.
Well, at least there's water in it.
Yeah.
What I want to do.
Now, if there's no water in that, that means that this probably burned up.
Well, if it's what it is, you got a propeller in there. And when
how do you prime it too?
Right there. Take that out.
Take this?
Yeah, you take that out and pour water in that hole.
What, this whole thing?
Twist it right out. And you peel it out.
Oh, shit. All right. I ended up.
You peel it up, put the thing back in it, and turn the pump on.
Is that where Benji said that where he, because he's at his pump, he put Clorox. Is that where he?
That's probably where you put it.
Well, a lot of people put this here. I got like mine. I got something coming up here, and then I got a thing on top I take out.
But my uncle said,
somebody else.
The main line.
I asked my mom's friend, and he's like, well, you should have something that you just take out from the top.
They didn't put it on this one.
Yeah, because he was confused.
And then my uncle said, well, there should be a straight line. And then he mentioned the filters that you were talking about, but I didn't know where to connect that at.
Yeah, that's probably why James, when he looked at it, he was confused. He's like, wait a second.
Do me a favor, Jim.
Yep.
I'm going to plug this saw. You come over here. Without busting anything.
I ain't busting nothing.
Let me get a screwdriver.
I may bust my head or my ass, but that's my own fault.
Still get electrocuted.
Nah, I'm alright with that.
Don't plug it up, touch it.
You don't hurt nobody.
Plug it up.
Oh.
Alright. Hand me a pair of pliers out of that bag over there. The big ones. Water on the pillow, frozen earth. or something. Should take on by itself.
I'm got a spark.
Go ahead and undo it.
Huh?
Unplug it.
Unplug it.
I got some big channel locks. Should be in that bag. Might run on the ground there. I don't know. I thought they were in that bag. Yep.
I hate those things. I always get them stuck. I'm like, damn it!
You hate them, but if you don't have them and need them,
yes,
you love them.
Yes.
So there could be water in here, but just a little piece of ice
there
that
is.
Can cause it from it's turning on.
Your pillows in there, that the ice is in there, pillows aren't going to kick on, which causes that thing to get hot and burn up. The pillow what gives it air and draws water.
So do we need to get
it could, murder could water? Be burned up or not.
Do we want to get a bottled water and pour it in there and melt the ice?
I don't know how thick it is thick, because it's all the way up to here.
I mean, if
we're dumping hot water in there,
might bust a head.
Yeah, that's because that's why I said
that's what I was figuring.
That's why it's like room temperature water.
God, that thing's froze solid.
Can't be that thick because the water came out of here, right?
Yeah, but that's on the bottom though. And you probably can't take a screwdriver and a hammer and drill a little hole through it, could you?
I mean, is this? I'm not going to hit nothing if I just go directly in the ice.
That's what I was wondering.
There it is. Just a little bit. I don't see any more ice down there. There's a hole now. There's water. Yeah.
All right, hold on a second. Let me pull it back up.
So the ice is like that much from the top.
There's a little strand of ice will hold that propeller from turning too, because there still might be around the propeller.
Because we weren't without water until I shut all the power off.
All right, plug it up.
Hopefully it fucking turns on.
Yeah, well, it's not, it's got to be something more to fucking deal with.
For a few days, yep. I mean, it's supposed to be...
When do I get paid again?
After New Year. Next Friday.
This upcoming Friday.
No. The 3rd, which is like next week. Like
10 days.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. 9, 10 days. Nine.
Yeah.
Let me see. Yeah, I gotta get melted. There's a jug of water bubble brought over here.
I gotcha.
Pull the insulation off back side of that pipe there, make sure you ain't busted on that side too.
That's what I was hoping for. I was like,
There's no, this insulation right here. That black piece.
This?
Yeah, pull that off. Make sure ain't none of that busted. Don't look like it. Maybe the water here's a little warmer. This is sitting in the jug.
It's gonna be, ours isn't hot inside, but we have those bottled waters that...
Guaranteed that propeller's froze.
And you can't unscrew this one here and then shove something in that side?
That's a bigger pipe. You got to cut it with a coupling.
Well.
You got to get all these bolts out to get the head off.
Fun.
Actually, I can stay hooked up probably. I can take these bolts out and pull the whole head off. Let's see. Maybe 4 bolts.
If not,
let me take this thing
out. I
got a
racket strap. Or a
plug it up.
Plug it.
Learning more about well systems than.
All right, unplug it. I need that bag. I don't know if I can brought the right side of this.
Where's our little toolbox at?
Wherever you put it last.
I think it's in the laundry room. Above the wash and dry.
I'm looking back on my truck and bring my big bag over here.
The one with the yellow stripe on it?
My tool bag. The little black one, the yellow one, stuff with all the tool wrenches in. Mm-hmm. Open up the hatch glass all over the whole hatch. And don't let go of that hatch glass.
That's funny how all that broke. I never seen PVC pipe break all at once.
Yeah, there's so much ice in it. Look at that huge ice cube in it. Yep, there's the ice. Yeah, I'm hoping that this pipe isn't froze, because that all just came out of that broken part. But that was cracked and then it probably froze. So that makes...
Well, that only let this thing turned off. It feels like it does. Yeah, that's off. Got to do a problem. I got to turn that off to the house. It's not in there, a problem. Got to keep going to the house. Oh, vacation.
Oh, nice.
Down in there and hold it. I got you. Yeah, hold this.
Why is that so loose? That's like...
Another thing, the bladder tank ain't locked.
The what?
The bladder tank. Take your finger and run around the edges there, get all the cut pieces off. Run on the outside. Just like that. All right. Take your cleaner.
Yep.
Run around that one.
On the outside?
Yep, outside. Where you do that bag of fittings?
It's right here. I was like, where'd he put it?
How's this can dented?
You didn't cuff them. You didn't know what that
was. The box had coupling on it.
Yeah, it's a female threaded adapter.
Fuck.
I got some couplings at the house bubbles up here.
Well then, I'll take those back and get the right ones then. So there's male and female.
I think I should fall back just on the outer edge. An inch from the edge. All right. They do the same thing to this one side of this. See that groove in there?
Mm-hmm.
Just running that groove around it.
Right. This is goats.
Yeah, she went shaking the treats.
Oh, that can. Come down here with it.
Yeah, I shook the treats and the ghosts all came running up
all
to the
eight,
fence.
However many ghosts he had, all six or eight of them, some bitches came bolting over towards the property. Like that's the wrong animal that we're trying to call. You want me to hold on?
Oh, that's got to sit, don't turn it.
All right.
It's got to sit there.
So you put this on the out on the outside, and then put this on the inside of the one that you want to fit on there, and then just
put
it on there, and then
you clean the outside, the inside, and you take the glue on the outside, and then glue on the inside or something too. Mm-hmm.
Alright, cool. Alright, got it. Alright, got that photo. I got the receipts in my wallet and the door.
If I could drive, I'd go there now and do it myself.
Nah, it's alright. It was like two something.
Huh?
It was like $2 and some change.
Or no, I meant like. While you sat here with them.
Surprisingly, it was a lot. I was expecting, my budget was to spend $100. It was nowhere near 50. I'm like, well, fuck. We finally bought a thermostat.
Which we have to fix anyways, so.
It was only $26.
Yeah. Yeah, we have to fix the thing anyways, because, I mean, but now the auto works.
Hey, your car. You say it's still running hot?
Yeah.
Is it leaking water?
No.
No. Radiator's in it. Everything's fucking connected.
No water's leaking inside the car on the floorboard?
No.
No.
The only other thing to make your thing run hot.
Thermostat.
You change thermostat?
No.
No.
Thermostat stuck.
Her mom's friend came
That's
over.
What he said. He said, call me and back. It's the thermostat. Worked,
and it didn't. He drove up and down Shaw Highway. I was like.
Water running in your floorboard?
No. There,
you ever see water running in your floorboard?
Yep.
Heater coil.
Uh-huh. Okay.
That's where you heat. But you can disconnect that hose, hook them together under the hood, and bypass your heater coil. You won't have heat.
Yeah, because the heat comes on for about 10 minutes and then goes cold again. And I was like, well, then the thermostat needs change, because I didn't know if your radiator goes, you should change the thermostat, because the thermostat
is cheap.
Well, a lot
of times the thermostat never opened, it was sticking to begin with, it caused the radiator to bust. It's not circulating.
Well, this one bust because it had a pinhole in it, but. Let me clean this up.
Nah, it's not threaded in anyway.
Yeah, I know James said.
You want it in there more?
Yeah, I got tied up with pliers.
All right.
Yeah, James said, call him back. He'll fix the thermostat. Because if it's still running hot for any reason, that's exactly what it is.
Because the thermostat is in a situation where he has to unhook like two or three things to get to it.
Yeah.
Mine was under my truck.
And thermostats are cheap.
Usually
so.
On top.
But so far, we're what, $800-$900 and the fixing this fucking thing is still.
It's cheaper.
We have plate money, and it has insurance on. We have plate money four different times, and then it still fucking can't make it to the goddamn inspection station in Hampstead.
Yeah, so we figure, well, we might as well pay this bill or buy this for.
All right. I'm still going to do that C&W, and then some guy's talking about he'll work with me if I trade it in. I'm like, well. As long as it's under $400 a month, I can afford it.
One in Burgle?
It's yeah. C&G.
Well, yeah, I was going to get.
His car's only like $200 a month, what mine was.
Well, yeah, but the cheapest down, his average down payment is like $2,500, $3,500,
and $4,500. Yeah, I put $3,000 on mine.
But see, I was going to say, if I was able to do like $500, well, I don't know if they're like dead set. Some places are.
Yeah,
because there's a guy who said that if you
but
have.
I just don't know what they would give me on a trade-in.
Yeah.
And their lowest trade-in was like, what, the median Blue Book value is $3,590 for our car. The average.
Yeah.
The lowest is $2,219.38, because I looked it up like 20 different times the last four days. Different sites.
Yeah.
And Kelly's Blue Book is like the one that never gives you shit. They gave me $2,100 as long as it runs. No motor. Then I think the lowest is like what, $1,200 or $1,300? One end goes in the one end there, goes into here, and then cut a piece of PVC pipe to fit them all together.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so I'm gonna have to do the.
You need a tape measure? Oh, you got one.
I can move this back so it should help me.
What, this?
Yeah, I'm gonna leave it there. It's gonna be hard for you to get the piece. I'm trying to see exactly where it's gonna go.
All of a sudden, whenever we were done and we were enjoying a cigarette and some conversation, fucking spider, this goddamn big came out from my fucking engine block, man. Scared us. You want to see about two grown ass men sound like some bitches?
Damn.
It, motherfucker was this big, bro. It was fucking like yellow and blue. It was a big ass wolf spider is what that bitch was. It like half his legs were standing up like you're about to jump. He hit it four times dead on with his stick. Fucker just ran. I'm like,
when I get ready to glue this piece in, I need to get down here. And I tell you, pull the bottom with a cup and a slide on it.
I pull it towards once it's once you're fitting it on.
All right. Once I get everything glued up, I'll tell you where to pull it. All right.
So once it's connected, I'm just going to slide it forward a tiny bit. Mm-hmm.
Back it up. Push it forward. Keep going. Keep going. Right there.
All right.
I'll hold it right there a minute. All right. Where's that for? Thank you. All right, Ed. Plug it up. Look at it. Unfolds it. If it does, then we can pick everything up.
So, how did freeze and then not warm up to like 60, like the early later on this week?
That's one thing. I don't lose nuts, bolts, and screws. I learned my lesson whenever I was like 10 years old. I got yelled at by my grandfather by misplacing one. Whenever he was working on his car. That's some serious shit.
Yeah, I never lost any either. I mean, you'd think I would be like ADHD and spazzy, but nope. They're like, if you lose one, you die. Okay. Walk around like this.
I always lose my half-inch ratchet strap or ratchet fucking thing, though. I always lost a few of those. It's always the top three that you always need for everything.
Yep.
I didn't lose them. Other people would use them and then
not
put them back.
It's probably people have like 16 different ratchet sets.
I got a shitload of it stolen from me.
They're all missing a few of them. Yeah.
It's always the fourth inch one or the fourth one or whatever.
Quarter inch.
Yes, yep. The quarter inch. Always. Fourth.
Yeah. You knew what you meant. What, four bolts?
Yeah.
Well, hopefully it's one of those, because I do know some engines, it's a safety mechanism, so they don't burn up. They totally shut down. But, regardless, if that's the case, we'll just have to wait till payday. We'll take showers at your mom's house. We'll make it work somehow. So.
Yep.
How they do it in the 1700s, they didn't have no damn electricity and shit. We'll be all right. The river. Yeah, fucking seriously.
Yeah, I'm a little, like, not that nature-bound to take an ice cold.
No, we can go to your mom's and do that.
That ain't good.
What?
It ain't want to come off. Well,
when was the last time this thing was off, too?
It probably slide right off because it's just two-piece. So something's got ice in it holding it together, or something melted in it.
There you go.
Yep, it's got ice in it. Got a little piece there. That's why I told the propeller not turning. If it would break loose, the pump would burn.
As far as my finger can reach, my longest finger.
Do you want something that's angled to try to break it up?
The ice is broken up, what I feel. I had that light on it for two fucking days. It should have melted something.
Well, that light bulb's not the
but
warmest.
But the top part, see, he let water out. So yeah. There's water in the bottom. And then the top part was, the ice was only about that thick, and then
yeah,
it was all water.
Yeah, but it's
So it shouldn't be ice in the middle of it. You wouldn't think so. Yeah, you're always coming loose. Yeah, there's ice in it. You want me to get room temperature water, or what do you think?
I can get it to come out a little. It'll come out, it'll slide out. Something might have melted in there.
Would it melt even though there's water inside of it?
Mm-hmm, because your
part would still melt?
Your stuff's not moving, so it's just melting.
Okay.
I mean, I bet it melt. I hope it's just frozen there.
Yeah.
But the way it's not coming over here.
Well, it's definitely been the
coldest,
earliest winter I've had here in 5 years since I've been in this state.
Yeah, last year didn't get this cold. I mean,
until like January.
Our pipes froze like one night and then they melted.
Never had this happen though. Yeah. But you turned it on and five minutes later,
right there,
warmed up. Huh? Right here?
Part of it.
Yeah.
Yes.
There she is. Yeah. There's a little bit of ice around it. Surface ice.
Mm-hmm. All right. Hey, what we gonna do?
Now, if it don't turn on, then the engine's fucked.
Let me get my screw. That's the wrong screwdriver.
Cause wouldn't that part be inside of here?
Plug it up.
I see all that water and electricity. I'm like, oh my gosh.
See, it's trying to turn. Oh, wait, unplug it a minute.
I didn't see anything try to move.
They got ice in it.
Okay, still a little bit more.
Let me spin this sucker down.
There's ice right here. There it is. Let's go. That's what you want to see.
This is why I'm recording it, because if this ever happens again, we need to do this.
So it was just the smallest amount of ice stopping it from turning.
Which sucks, but makes sense, and at least it
moved. But it moved. That's what you wanted to see.
Yes. At least it's not like we have to replace the motor.
So you got it made where you can change the motors and leave the head on there.
Huh?
You can change the motor up, you can find. That's why they got four bolts on them.
Yeah.
Propellers.
But what kind of motor is it though? What, how many, what horsepower?
Probably half.
Yeah, that's a lot there. Does it be a certain size or any half? Because I always might as well, you know, being that it's fixed, it's still, you know, eventually buy an extra one just in case something happens.
Yeah, that's what I said.
Well, now I'll know what to fucking look for, and it'll be sealed, and it'll be a fucking light on. He never told us.
And that's why
I asked
also
him specifically before we got this place, do I need to do anything with this? He told me about the clean your water and shit with the different solutions, and that was it.
Yeah.
So.
Because he said he did everything before, like the year prior.
And then I had a few questions after everything went through, and he fucking changed his number and never caught. He blocked me on Facebook.
He's a dick. I can't stand him.
Nobody
almost
can.
Almost killed him.
Yeah. There's my leg. I'm like, what the fuck is the cat?
Yeah,
it looked just like Whiskers, my grandma's cat. Whenever I was like 14, whenever that damn cat died.
Now I put the 40 watt and not the 12 watt in there. So he said we need a big bulb like this. That's why I took a picture of.
Because we have like three different sizes inside of.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's called a heat bulb.
Huh?
Yeah, the heat bulbs.
Oh, you want an actual heating bulb.
Like the terrarium ones, like the lizard ones.
The
aquariums.
Yeah,
Yeah, just not a red one, but yeah.
Yeah, the blue one. I know what they're called, but I just can't think.
Yeah, when he said that, I was like, oh yeah, okay.
Yeah, they're like $8.
But they last forever. Yeah, he realized that all he needed was another elbow, because then he could have cut this shorter and just. But it works.
Shabam.
All right. What was it?
There's both of them. Now I got to put water
you
in.
You see the way they had it? It was like a maze like this.
Do you want to go get your funnel? And, oh, your funnel's in the car, isn't it?
I put the water in there.
Poured the water in there.
I mean, I can dump it in there, yeah.
Well, I was just thinking a funnel would make it go faster. I don't know. I don't know. Because I don't think I have another funnel.
Is that me leaking it?
Yeah, it's you.
I don't know.
Yeah, because it's bouncing off.
Underneath from the...
Yeah,
it's
Okay, well, all right. Like, damn, you got a hole in it.
Yeah, it's just going like this up underneath the funnel.
Yeah, I looked like it was leaking, but then, yeah, I seen what he seen.
I could tell because it was bouncing off this side. That's what I knew it was.
Yeah, boy, these bad dogs of ours, man, had me.
Hey, don't do it though yet.
Right. No, they usually, last time the dogs got loose
for
a little while, they were in, like, in your back, in your guys' backyard, because all of a sudden here comes Blade around the corner with a wagging his little butt. I'm like, excuse you, sir.
Boy.
I don't see any leaks. The insulation?
Huh?
The insulation?
What?
Insulation.
Yeah.
Okay. That's what I thought he said. I swear you're a cat. There is a cat. Well, I know it's not one of mine because they're all inside. Is there on my fence line or your fence line? It's over there somewhere. Meow meows! Meow meows!
Oh,
yeah.
Plug it up.
Plug it up.
What happened?
Oh, he's there too. On this back side, I don't want to put on.
Uh-oh.
That's the same. That ain't my pipe. Plus it was leaking right here.
Huh?
It was leaking from the pump too.
So it's leaking here and here?
Right here.
Fuck.
You want to plug in the light again so I can shine it? Because it's...
Yeah, I think the thing's busted. Bubble.
Yep.
How many elbows are in that bag? Two?
Yep.
The plastic casing cracked.
It's because he was leaking
water from there, eventually burned the motor up.
That's what he was afraid of when you left.
I got a Flex Seal.
See one of my works.
What the fuck? You want me to plug this light up?
Yeah. just because it's getting a little dark and I want everybody to see.
Of course, I was so light light here. I need four of them. I did that ball. I'm going to put it back here, putting the elbow like this. And another elbow facing that way. Same way man. There. Yeah, I guess there's a split in here somewhere. Right there.
Right here? Yep. So you need, what, two more of these?
Mm-mm. How many couples did you buy?
Huh?
How many couples did you buy?
Just that one that you told me.
What time does tractors?
You need another one?
What time do they close?
The hardware?
Yeah.
I don't know. I mean, it's only 5:21.
Yeah.
Dang, I don't know what was leaking here.
I didn't see water spewing out of here.
Yeah, I saw it.
All right, I never filmed an outro to the well system, and I didn't really show you guys like the finished thing. We had to get a light for it, as you guys heard. Luckily, one of our neighbors gave us a light, so we don't have to buy a light. So that's good. We just have to put it out there. And little man's fussy right now. He's not hungry. He just ate. But yeah, so, well, you guys are going to have to listen to me over him. But yeah, so. All right, so I never really got around to telling you guys about the well system, the finished product. So basically, as you saw, we fixed the well system. Luckily, our neighbor did give us a light because we did put a light bulb out there that was a little bit brighter. It produced more heat, so it kept the pipes from freezing. Actually, on that note, I should actually go out there and plug this other light in because tonight it's going to be 36 degrees. It's January 6th. And obviously I had the triplets, so yay. I did have the triplets when I was filming that video. It feels like it was like forever ago. Anyways, so the one pipe that runs from the well system to the house might need to be cleaned. We did not get around to get any like cleaner, well system cleaner or anything. I know that they have that depending on what, is built up in your well system. It could be copper, it could be iron, it could be calcium. There's a whole bunch of different minerals. I think there might be an all mineral well system cleaner. Not really sure. I did Google it way back when. Considering that when I let the water drip in my bathtub, it stains the bathtub yellow. That's why if you guys ever see any of my videos where I film the bathrooms and you think that my tubs and my shower is really, really dirty. It's not. It's the well water buildup from all the copper. It's very common in well water. It's very common in older well systems. But I think that pipe that runs from the well system to the house needs to be cleaned out. Eventually, hopefully, we can get around to doing that. But when we ran the water again, the cold water had the sediments that had to come out of it. Like, and when I say sediments, it looks like dirt's coming out of your faucet, if that makes sense. Not like dirt, like very, like rust. You know how if you ever brush a rusty thing off and you get like the rust particles, that's what it's, comes out of our faucet. So basically, we just had to let the water run, especially in our showers. Now, I have a filter head on my shower, so speaking of that, I might want to clean out that filter system. It did seem to make my hot water in my shower run faster, so that's good. The kitchen sink, we have a Brita filter on. However, we might have to buy a completely new Brita filter system, only because when we were trying to run the hot water through the Brita filter, I think all the buildup from the well system made the Brita filter not really work as well. It still works. The water is still drinkable. It just takes a while to run through. But yeah, so it doesn't smell like well water anymore. It doesn't smell like, our system never smelled like rotten eggs or anything. It kind of almost smelled like wet dog, if that makes sense. I don't know if that was the copper that smelled like wet dog or if it was the iron buildup. I'm not really sure which one. I'm assuming it was the I'm not sure. It's hard to explain unless you have well water yourself or if you've been around somewhere that has well water. But I will say it's never had that rotten egg smell. But yeah, the hot water works great. We still have to get the cleaner system. Somebody a long time ago said you could just put bleach into it. I'm not really sure. I would go and take you guys outside after Jim like is here and show you guys. But the lid is back on it, and the lid to the well system like weighs like 4 million pounds. So I probably can't lift that myself. If you see my eyes like this, it's because of the glare, and I'm super tired, obviously, you know. But yeah, so that was the video, and if you guys have any questions, comments, concerns, Jim's calling me, so let me answer this really fast. All right, so yeah, that was pretty much the video of us cleaning out our well system. I tried to leave it as unedited as possible. I know our conversations probably got, like, boring, like, a lot of parts. And if you have any questions, comments, thoughts, or concerns, or advice, you guys can leave this below or you can email me as well. Because the well system is new and we're learning. It was a great learning curve. Learned a lot about a well system and how to do it. It was a lot easier than, personally, I thought it was a lot easier than what it seemed like. And other than that, you guys have a great rest of the year. Bye.